Now, Black Mirror has already given us plenty of promo for a doomsday future that's probably awaiting us. With technology getting more enhanced and independent, the world's getting creepier. From being frozen in time, to being killed without a trace, the grip on our own lives is going, going, and gone. Let's take a look at the creepy technologies that are coming to the world by the year 2030. The Undead. You know what's creepy? The living dead. If you haven't heard of necrobiotics yet, well, you're in for a surprise. The cutting-edge technology is about to transform lifeless creatures into robots. Yep, you heard that right. This may sound like a plot straight out of a horror movie, but it's actually being developed at Rice University. A team of researchers have already turned a dead spider into a robotic gripper with the power to pick up other objects. So, how exactly did they do it? They did it by injecting air into the spider. Apparently, this works because spiders rely on hydraulics to move their limbs. This futuristic technology is still in its early stages, but it is exciting to think about a future where dead animals could be used for scientific advancement. Although, if I'm being honest, it does feel a little bit like something out of Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. Kill at sight. Remember the plot for Captain America: The Winter Soldier? Using folks' bad credit score and test scores, Hydra was building a machine to wipe out candidates they best guess could turn rogue. Now, that future is not very far off. Killer drones are no longer a fantasy from sci-fi movies. Thanks to recent advancements in AI and drone technology, we're now looking at creepily precise technology. Coordinated swarms of drones are being built that can track and eliminate targets with shocking accuracy. Take China's Zhejiang University, for instance. Their researchers had developed a drone swarm that can track humans through dense bamboo forests without any human intervention. Can you believe that? That means these killer drones can autonomously hunt down targets in areas where humans can't even reach them. But that's not all. Halcon, a subsidiary of UAE's Edge Group, has unveiled its Hunter 2S swarming drone system. This bad boy can exchange information between drones to locate and engage targets, making it even deadlier than your average killer drone. The worst part? Drones like these can be a cost-effective and efficient way to take out enemies without risking any human lives. To know that your one bad move can get a killer drone on your tail kinda makes me gulp a little bit. Costly love affair. Now, dating apps are working for no one, but that doesn't mean you hop aboard the sex doll train straight away. Sex dolls are now taking a back seat because sex robots have made waves in the past decade. The anatomically correct sex doll was released in 2010 by True Companion, and it broke the internet. Nobody could decide if they were traumatized by this or excited. But it was a hit nonetheless. Since then, many more companies are taking out even more enhanced versions of these sex robots. With robotics and AI both advancing, it's only a matter of time before these robots become lifelike. But maybe even sex robots are about to be a thing of the past. In a disturbing pre-pandemic report, futurist Dr. Ian Pearson gave us shocking facts. By 2050, there will be a large population of androids. Most of us would be having sex with machines. And that human-to-human sex will be replaced by virtual reality. Despite the fact that VR porn has not yet gained widespread acceptance, the sex industry is booming, with more diverse options and possibly by the internet, virtual reality, digital platforms and hookup applications, artificial intelligence and advancements in 3D printing. Either way, the world is already crippled with self-isolation. It would just be a matter of time before we lose the human connection and touch at the cost of fake sex. Frozen 2.0. Now, we haven't found the Fountain of Youth yet, but we have found a way to avoid permanent death altogether. How does freezing in time and reviving once AI and medicine is super advanced sound to you? Well, cryopreservation is an option. Alcor is already a well-known foundation that has frozen a certain number of subjects. But without our fixation on defying ageism and conquering life, we bet this trend will catch on. Wait, isn't this exactly what happened to Steve Rogers? Yes! Yes, it is. But he's not the only notable man to have been frozen. James Bedford, Ted Williams, John Henry Williams, and Dick Clare Jones are some hotshot names who are already frozen. And several celebrities who are still alive desire to be frozen, such as Seth MacFarlane, Larry King, Simon Cowell, Paris Hilton, and Britney Spears. Of course, this tech is also now being studied by NASA to create a better form of hibernation for its astronauts. That'll make traveling in space super efficient. You merely need to watch 2001 A Space Odyssey or Interstellar to see this vision come to life. Although the technology to freeze humans is far from perfect, and there is a chance that there could be permanent harm, it gets better every year. But get this, there is currently no technology available to defrost individuals. So, ready to become a popsicle, folks? Or does debt suddenly feel inviting? Either way, this form of life seems horrible, creepy, and downright strange. Real or deepfake? Deepfake technology is taking over the world, and it's not for the better. Sure, this technology has its merits, such as recreating historical figures for educational purposes or helping those with disabilities. But folks on the internet have discovered a potential for its malicious use. Using deepfake technology, anyone can create fake images and videos of anyone they desire. Maybe the fun AI Instagram account that parodies Keanu Reeves' face will make you understand this better. The scariest part of these deepfakes have become so realistic that it's often hard to distinguish between real footage and digital fakes. Now, with the rise of the metaverse, where we spend more and more time in virtual worlds, the need for identity verification is super crucial. It's highly likely that in the coming decade, most of our jobs will be integrated with AI and VR. Channeling deepfake technology to do a little identity theft will never be easier. Makes us shudder thinking that we could be spilling tea to our office bestie, but in reality, it's your boss. Yikes. Editing humans. We've all hit the undo button on our notepads too often to count. Now, if you could erase the very human genome of all defects, would that weird you out? We're all born with some anomalies. Something as small as an extra digit to some incurable genetic disease. We now have the ability to alter inheritable genes in plants, animals, and our own bodies, thanks to CRISPR-Cas9 technology. Gene editing has enormous advantages, since it can prevent sickness and correct genetic mutations that lead to life-threatening illnesses. But rumor has it, there's a shocking possibility that people will look into curating babies devoid of any disease, and maybe get sex or facial preferences incorporated too. Playing God never works well, does it? Powerful nanobots. Now, we've seen way too many Marvel movies to not know the scope of nanobots. There are easily excellent uses for this technology, including collection and transmission of data, medicine delivery, and sample taking. But when has great power ever come without a great risk? Researchers have created nanobots, or small robots at a nanoscale, which can cross the brain-blood barrier and enter the human bloodstream. But that means nanobots will be able to bridge the gap between AI and brain control. From memory modification to attaining immortality. Selling ourselves to nanobots is the future. Kurzweil, the former Google scientist, has predicted a complete nanobot takeover in the coming decades. But in our contemporary society of increasingly connected technologies, there are also significant privacy problems. The real question is, will we have any privacy in the nanobot world? Will our medical information be safeguarded? To provide openness and stop these issues, strict regulation and control will be crucial. Think of this, nanorobots to target cancer cells at a cellular level has already been made, but what if these same cells could target living and healthy cells? Scary prospects, right? AI domination. Today's powerful AI algorithms can perform better than people on many levels, so say goodbye to your job. Experts say that 80 to 90% of all present jobs will be enhanced by AI, and many of them will even become wholly obsolete. We need to consider how to get ready for this change and be flexible enough to perform the tasks that can only be completed by humans. Artificial intelligence is progressing toward thinking at the level of humans in many ways. It's safe to say that in some ways, we're already past the AI singularity, a possible future where AI surpasses human intelligence. I mean, ChatGPT was able to pass the US MLE exam. There's no knowing where their development takes them, and how soon we become obsolete. It is an uncertain and creepy future ahead of us, folks. And that is a wrap, folks. Which technology are you most creeped out by? Comment below and tell us. And if you like this video, we'd really appreciate if you give it a thumbs up, and maybe even subscribe and hit that bell notification icon so you're notified every time that we post new videos just like this one. And we'll see you next time. Take care.